Or did you like it? Tell me you can make me that you like it. Type of love that make you wanna wife it up. Tell me you can make me that you like it, like it, like it, like it.
What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Nicole J.
Hey, what's first? And you're watching my channel.
Boop.
So,
hey, my Smurfs.
I haven't had a talk video in a long time. Like, just plainly talking, it's been a while. Before we get into this video, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and turn that bell. So, today, what did I do? Oh, okay, so today I had I was filming like a sort of community college, commercial. If you live in North Carolina, Wake Tech, that rings a bell. That's what I was doing. Here's some clips from that today.
I got it. I'm going back to school.
But anyways, so this video is all about my first year college experience. Let's get straight into it. So, as y'all know, if you've been a subscriber or been watching my channel since the move-in, I was actually on campus through August through November. And that time, I'm gonna be honest, everybody has their own college experiences, and mine, I'm trying to say it in the nicest way, but like, I'm just gonna be real. Like, I didn't like it. Like, I'm not the most outgoing person, so that could be like a thing. But then COVID, it's really hard to find new people. And like, the roommate I did have, she was barely there. She went home like every weekend. So I was, I'll be honest, I was feeling really depressed. Most of the time I was there, I was alone. The only thing that really kept me going is like having to go to Kaplan and dancing choreography, and then also TikToks. Like, this is really what like kept my mind. Like, I was really depressed, I felt lonely, I was really sad. And it was even more sadder because you see all your acquaintances from high school on social media, and they're all, we're in college, having fun, seeing them doing all this stuff, and you're just in your dorm like watching Vanessa Ferb, very sad. And I called my mom every single day because that was really the highlight of my day. I tried not to cry because I didn't want her to see me sad. Like, I didn't want anybody to know I was sad. I just wanted to tuck it on my own. But really, I was just really sad. But as far as the work, I think it was pretty decent. To me, it was about the same as high school. About, like, I just kept an agenda, kept organized. And I did well that first semester as far as classes, but as far as like mentally and like emotionally, yeah, like it was like a 2. Like, I had a really hard time, and every time I talked about it, like if you go back in my later vlogs when I was on campus, I could barely keep the tears from running down. Like, I was just like really depressed, and I felt really lonely, and I was just not enjoying it. And like, I just felt like this isn't for me. And like, I keep hearing people saying college isn't for everyone. And that moment, that was like the longest time ever. I was homesick. I'm used to being around people. I just did not like it. And I was like, college isn't for everybody. And I'm a very shy person. And like, it's really, communication with other people was like really hard for me. And then COVID made it another barrier. And I just sat alone at lunch, sat by myself. Always rather be by myself. And that's just how my mentality was. And if I really tried to get out of the depressed state, I just go do a TikTok or go to Kaplan or work out, anything else. But honestly, that first semester was really hard, and that was really long. So I made the decision, called my parents and said, hey, this is not working. I don't like this. I don't want to waste money. So November, when I saw their faces come and bring the moving stuff, y'all, I literally cried. I was so excited because, like, it was just so bad. So I came home, second semester, The class, now it was the classes. The classes was really difficult. I think it's because everything was online and it was hard to really manage because none of them had Zooms. I had to like manage my own time and what, like estimate that. Like that was really difficult. This is COVID times we're talking about. So college is very different. But so I was home for the second semester and like mentally and emotionally, like I was great. Like that was the happiest I've ever been. I was able to figure out my anxiety issues, health issues, like get that resolved stuff. Like honestly, my mental health and my emotional is way more important than getting an A or B. Like I could care less about a grade or how hard a class is, but if I'm sad and depressed, that doesn't matter. I care about my well-being more. So home was great, babies was here, got to spend time with them, got to see family. I really had like the second semester was really it for me. It made me like, so like, do I like just the, I don't know what, how college is going to work for me. I had a really, like, I've been thinking the past couple days, like, dang, like, what is the next step? Do I stay here, go to a community college, or do I stay doing strictly online? Even though it's going to be challenging, but would I rather for my mental health to be better? I don't know. I'm just really confused. Still am, but I have made a decision to try again this fall semester at UNCG, and I'm hoping for something. I'm giving it one last semester because you don't want to be wasting money that it can be put somewhere else. So I'm giving it one last time, and like me as a person, I'm actually going to try to put an effort. But I'm not gonna go too far out of my comfort zone because it's just me and like, I don't know. I'm gonna just try more. I don't know. I'm still really confused and nervous because I really don't wanna be in that depressed state that I was in again. Like y'all don't understand. Like y'all saw me on the camera, but like I was really a mess, really hard. Just eating and just in sadness. It was like, really hard, y'all. Like every time I think about it, it's just, it was rough. But anyway, so I have decided to try again. So hopefully I find one person. I'm not looking for 5 people, 7 people. That's never been me. I've never been the one to have a bunch of friends. I've always had one at least who was there and somebody I can like, yeah, that's someone I can talk to. So hopefully I find someone to like that connection, or maybe just have a better experience at all. And all, and like, yeah, this semester is going to be very important because this is going to help me decide what path am I actually going to take. Will I stay and finish these 4 years, or will I come back home and work and do community college or figure out my next steps? So this semester is very important to me, and y'all will be coming on my journey of my second year, and I can't wait for that. But as we're wrapping up my freshman year of college, I give it a whopping boop. It's just me. And if you're new senior or high schooler excited to go to college, everybody's experience is different, and it's COVID times, and you know your personality. That's what I want you to say. I'm talking to you. You know your personality. You know who you are. Don't let anybody pressure you into going. You know yourself and if it's the right move for you. If you need to wait for you to grow a little, then you do that. You don't rush into it. Do what you feel. I know your parents or other guardians might have a say in something, but sometimes it really is up to you, and you know yourself, and I know myself, so this is why I'm giving myself this last chance, because I know I didn't try as much, so I'm going to try as much as I believe I should, you know. And then from there I will decide. If it doesn't work out, then yeah, we'll figure out a new journey for me, and that's just part of life. And you know, I just wanted to get on here and let y'all know like what did I think of college and what my first year and what do I think I'm going next. So yeah, this is just really for my high schoolers or my seniors out there that are still excited. I'm excited for you. Be excited. Don't let my bumness bum you out. Be excited. Be happy. I know a lot of my friends that were scared but had a great experience. And my friends that were happy and excited had a great experience. But the difference for me, when I was little, high school, I was never the type to be like, can't wait to go to college, gonna have so much fun. That was never me. I was never thinking about, oh my gosh, college is gonna be so fun. That wasn't me. Like, I was always like, away from fam, that's not really my thing. Family's really close to me. So yeah, like, if you're like me and you're like in high school and you're like, I'm not really excited about it, take a long, deep thought, write it out, and think about what you want to do. Don't let social media or your acquaintances make you feel that you have to do it to be like, not cool necessarily, but like with your age group. Because I myself am definitely behind my age group. I have a different mentality. I may not be as fun as some, which I feel like that was on campus. That's what I felt like. Everybody was, their fun is not my fun. And sometimes I feel like I'm boring and I'm just not connected to my age group. Sorry, don't want to run. And that's how I just feel sometimes. So I just set myself back and I'm just like, I'd just rather be by myself. But it wasn't healthy for me, so I'm gonna try to put myself out there, and yeah, let's see what happens. And if you're watching this and you're young, excited for college, be excited. But if you're watching this and you're like me and you're really like, I don't know if it's for me, really dig deep down. And if you feel like you need to wait 2 years, do that. Do not rush. Do not think you have to be so in tune with your age group. Everybody grows at different paces. Everybody has their own idea of fun. Everybody has different personalities. Do not try to bend the way you are for an age group or to be such a thing. Because anybody knows me, I've never been the one to do that. I've always been the weirdo, like, oh, she's quiet. All rings on my fingers, just doing quiet. Sometimes, like, oh, she can dance. Oh, she kind of loud. Like, I'm just surprising because you never know. I'm always going to be true to myself. And once you learn me, then you'll learn the different sides of me. You know, everybody has their own, like, fleshing out of personality. And when you first see me, it's kind of the quiet side and a little, like, maybe boring to you because I'm not interested into the cool things, you know, people 19 years are into. Sorry, that's not my tea. That's not my flow of things. But I feel like I'm pretty a dope person and like somebody out there would love to be my friend. And I would love to be theirs, you know. I don't want to say I'm excited for a semester. That's not how I feel. I'm kind of in the same boat I was last time, like, sad, don't really want to leave, don't want to feel that emptiness again, but I know this is something I got to do. I said about it, prayed about it, and this is something that is necessary. I have to try again. I can't just quit. So that is what I'm doing, and yes, I'm really nervous, but I'm hoping for the best. And if it's not the best, I move on, choose a different path. And that's what I love most about myself. I never quit. And that's been a whole life thing with health, anxiety. I never quit. It might get hard. And I just gotta turn a new path, find a new avenue of how to succeed. And this life thing is different. I'm still trying to find myself. A lot of different things are happening. Stuff that I would never imagine happening. But I'm going through it right now. And it's just exploring. But anyway, this is mostly about college, back on track. But that's all I wanted to say. My update, I gave it up on my first year, but that's not for everybody, just for me. And next semester, we'll see if that boop goes up to the boop. So yeah, I love you guys so much. And honestly, if it wasn't for y'all, I don't know. Like, you, God, my family, and yeah, like y'all, like documenting it and able to semi-speak was really good for me, and I had fun with that. And all the dances I recorded at Kaplan for you guys that you enjoyed. It really started off with a whole lot of choppas. It's when it blew up, and it was nice to see that when I was going through it. So I'm really just hoping for the best, you know? Never know, having a lot of good footage, new creative content. If you have any ideas, drop it down in the comments below for me, please. And please follow all the socials below. I forget to say this every time. Follow them so you can keep up to date and so you can interact with me. Especially now when we're small. But when we get big, it might be hard to interact with everybody. But for right now, I get to interact with y'all. But I love you guys so much. And like I said, you know yourself. College isn't for everybody. That term is not generic at all. It is not. So don't feel obligated to feel like that's your next step after high school. It's not for everybody. But if it is for you, I'm happy. But if it's not, don't feel like you are a failure because you're not. You'll always stay there. But I'm not a failure. I just am different. And everybody's different. Anyways, I love you guys. Like, comment, subscribe, and turn on that bell. Thank you for listening and my conclusion of my freshman year and my college experience and how I really felt about the whole process. I love you guys so much. Thank you, my friends, for coming on with this journey. In the fall, we'll be back on this journey again. But for right now, it's summertime. Let's be free. Let's have a good time. Let's have fun. Let's let loose some. But make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and turn that bell. I love you guys so much, my Smurfs. Yeah. It's your girl, Nicole J. Bye, my Smurfs. Just because I ain't ready to